Okay, students. Now let us see past perfect tense. So, what is the usage of this past perfect tense? When there are two actions completed in the past, for the first action, for the earliest action, we use past perfect tense. That is the definition. See, to denote an action which was completed before another past action. So, do you think there was only one past action? In the past, there can be only one completed actions in the past. No, right? There might be two or three or four actions at a time. It may happen, or one before the other. It may happen. So, for example, let two actions completed in the past. So, for the first action, which action happened first, completed first? For that first action, we should use past perfect tense. So, for the next action, for the second action, which action completes after this first action, for that second action, we should use simple past tense. Is it clear, everybody? Okay, now let's see the structure. This is the structure: subject plus had plus V3 plus object. So, now let's see some examples. Now, you have to tell me which action happened first and which action happened second. The movie had already started before we entered. Can you tell me? Which action happened first? Yes, movie had already started. Movie completed first. Movie started. This is the first action. So, to understand clearly, I am explaining like this. So, you also take these numbers to understand clearly so that you can easily arrange the sentences and you can easily decide which action is first, which action is next. So, if it is first, we should use past perfect tense. We should use this structure. If it happens second, next action, further we should use simple past. So, if you analyze like this, then you can easily decide to use which structure and you can decide it belongs to which tense also. So, the movie had already started before we entered. First movie started, next we entered. Okay, this action happened first. After movie started, then we were late to that theater. So, we entered next. Before we entered, movie started already. Next, I had washed dishes before maid came. So, what happened? Washing dishes happened first. So, what is next? Maid came. This is the next. So, this action had happened before this action. That's why here I am using the linker before. Or you can also use this tense. This is simple past, right? So, you can use this sentence here and this sentence here. So, if you exchange that places, can you tell me which linker we have to use? Yes, maid came after I had washed dishes. Here we are changing just linker. That's it. Action is not changing. The serial number is also not changing. The first action is in the first only after changing also. Second action is in the second place only. But just we are changing the linker. That's it. We can use before. We can use after. We can use when. If both action happen at a time, we can use when. Next example, we had finished our lunch before my father brought biryani. So, their father brought biryani. So, they have been waiting for that biryani. So, after that some time, they were feeling hungry. So, they ate the lunch. So, we had finished our lunch. First, which action happened first? This action happened first. So, that's why we have used past perfect tense here. Clear? Subject plus had plus V3. Next, here before. So, by seeing this before, clearly we can understand that this action had happened before and this is the first action. So, for this we should use past perfect tense. So, after this before, my father brought biryani. Brought is a V2 form. So, this is the second action. After eating lunch, he brought biryani. What is the use? No one is going to eat that, right? So, we had finished our lunch before my father. So, can you tell me by using after, how to exchange the places? Very easy, right? just we should bring this second sentence here and we should keep it here. Here we should use, in the place of before we should use after. That's it. My father brought biryani after we had finished our lunch. So students, this is all about past perfect tense. Now let's see some more examples. Let's see the combination of simple past and past perfect tense.